Hello friends, my name is Mohsin Mullah and I welcome you all to this video lecture. So today I'm gonna start with the new subject Power System 2 of your TY class. Okay, so Power System 2. So in this particular subject, what exactly we are gonna do is actually we are gonna do the power system analysis. Here we are basically going to do the power system analysis. Okay, so what is power system analysis? So in order to understand that, we need to first understand what is power system. So power system is nothing but basically whatever electricity or electric energy that we consume at our domestic applications or industrial applications. Okay, so though that electricity or electrical energy is basically generated at a very far away place and it is being transmitted over a very long distance with the help of transmission lines, and that electricity is then finally it reaches to the consumers or the whatever domestic consumers or industrial consumers. Okay, so therefore basically the power system involves first of all the generator. Okay, so the generating station, then from the generating station the whatever energy is generated, electrical energy is generated, it is stepped up, okay, to higher voltage, and that stepped up voltage is transmitted to a very long distance. Okay, so with the help of transmission lines, and when it reaches to the final destination, then it is stepped down to required voltage value, and then it is finally given to consumers. Okay, so now these all stages in the transportation of electricity, right from the generation till the transportation, is considered as a power system. Okay, so wherein it consists of a generating station. Okay, it consists of a generating station. Okay, so then transmission and finally distribution to the consumers. Transmission and distribution. Okay, so these aspects are considered as of the electricity transportations are together considered as a power system. So now here we are going to see about various aspects of this power system under the subject power system 2, or here basically it is nothing but power system analysis. So the very first unit deals with the economic operation of power system. Now what is economic operation of power system? Economic word indicates that so when we are using some capital investment in doing some activity, then we are expecting that we definitely are going to get some profit from it. So that is called as economic operation. Okay, so now here whatever electricity is being supplied to us, it is actually coming from where? It is coming from the generating station. So at the generating station, the here I'll just try to show the generating station like this. So this generating station here, okay, so is going to generate the electricity, and that electricity will be with the help of transformers, it will be with the help of a transformer, it will be supplied at a higher voltage to the transmission line, which will be transmitted over a very long distance. Then finally it is going to be given to different types of consumers. So there will be consumers which are we can say domestic consumers, okay, as well as there are some industries also we can consider. Okay, so then there will be big industries also available which will continuously consume this electricity. Okay, so like this. So these all require electricity. So the power system is going to generate the electricity and transmit to these loads here. So when it is generating the electricity, so now here this is called as the power plant. Okay, so the utilities, or the you can say the power generating companies, or basically the power companies, they need to generate this electricity. So to generate the electricity, what they require is operational cost. Okay, so they have to use some operational cost. So now that operational cost basically involves what? So there are different components in the operational cost. The very first component or the principal component in the operational cost is the fuel cost. Okay, because all the power plants definitely require fuel for their operation. So the fuel cost is the major component of the you can say the overall operational cost of the power plant. Then there will be labors. So we have to pay for the labor charges. Okay, so those people working in the power system, so their salaries, their pensions, etc., will be considered as the labor charges. Then also there will be some other type of say transportation, etc., kind of some transportation type of we can say expenditures will be there. So that also we can consider here. So these together will form the operational cost. Okay, so here depending upon the type of power plant, so this operational cost will vary. Suppose we are using, suppose the power plant being used here is a thermal power plant. Okay, so thermal power plant or a nuclear power plant. So for both of these thermal power plant and nuclear power plant, so the operational cost is high because here fuel is required. Fuel is required, and when the fuel is required, obviously the operational cost is going to be, you can say, considerably high here as compared to the hydroelectric power plant. So in case of a hydroelectric power plant, basically hydroelectric power plant does not require, hydropower plants are essentially have negligible operational cost. Only the initial installation is required for the hydropower plant, then it has negligible operational cost, because here fuel for the hydropower plant is nothing but water. Water is free. Okay, so water is free, therefore operational cost here will be negligible, because the only cost that will incur is because of the few people working in the hydroelectric power plant. Apart from that, there is no additional cost of operation for the hydroelectric power plant. But while in case of thermal or nuclear power plant, so these power plant definitely require you can say fuel for their operation. So therefore they are going to have very large operational cost. So now we are going to talk this economic operation with regards to only the thermal power plants or nuclear power plants. As in India, we know that the majority of power plants operating for generating the electricity are thermal power plants. So therefore we are going to concentrate our understanding based on the thermal power plants only. We are not going to use you can say the thermal nuclear or hydroelectric power plants. Okay, so therefore now let us consider the operational cost of a thermal power plant. So in thermal power plant, basically, okay, so what will be available thermal power plant, when you consider, so its fuel is definitely the coal. Okay, and in case of a thermal power plant, there will be a number of units. So I'll just try to give you one idea by drawing some rough picture or rough image of a thermal power plant here. Suppose this is the thermal power plant. Okay, and here this chimneys are available at certain height, so which will be continuously taking away the exhaust. Okay, so smoke, fumes, everything with the help of these chimneys. Okay, and each of this whatever I have drawn, so this can be considered as a unit. Okay, so here we can take this as a unit 1, here this can be taken as unit 2, unit 3, unit 4, unit 5. Now what is a unit? So unit is nothing but it is a single unit is nothing but it is combination of one unit So I'll just try to show you what is the unit. Unit involves a boiler. Okay, so here basically it is nothing but a boiler plus turbine, okay, plus turbine, and then the generator. The generator. Okay, so this is called as a unit. Okay, so one unit involves one boiler, turbine, and generator. So when this unit is used, it is going to have its own kind of curve. Okay, so that curve is, suppose if I take one particular unit here, so that unit is going to have its own type of curve. So let us keep this point here. So now each of the unit is going to have its own performance curve. So what do we mean by that? So suppose we have a setup, one boiler, turbine, and generator. So we are going to supply the fuel to it, and it is going to produce the power. So when we take the power generation to the fuel consumption, okay, so when we take cost of fuel, okay, cost of fuel here on y-axis, and on x-axis if you take the power generated, so then we will get, as the power generation will increase, obviously fuel requirement will increase, therefore the cost of fuel will increase. So when the power generation is lower, at that time the fuel required is lower and the cost of fuel will be lower. So by understanding that, what we can say is that, so there will be a curve of this fuel cost versus power generated. So that will look like this. So now this curve is having two ends. So here we can take this as power generated minimum, PG minimum, and here we can take this as PG maximum. Okay, so this power will be usually in terms of megawatts. Here also it is in terms of megawatts. Okay, so now when the power generated is minimum, in that case the fuel cost will be lower, and when the it will correspond to this value, and when the power generated is maximum, then the fuel cost is going to be this much. Now what is this two ends indicate, PG minimum and PG max? So now basically the generator is designed to generate a particular amount of power, so that is its maximum capacity. So here PG max indicates the maximum capacity that generator can produce the power. Now PG minimum is, this is the, you can say, power generation which is economical, or which is you can say minimum power generation has to be there if the that overall setup needs to be working technically. Okay, so therefore if you want to generate it less than this PG minimum, then we are going to compromise either the efficiency of the generator or the overall operation of the setup unit. So therefore it is to always generate the power above this PG minimum value. Okay, so in between, anywhere it can be generated. So now for each of the unit there will be a separate curve, because it involves a different boiler, different turbine, as well as a different generator. Therefore the curve whatever we are plotting here, it is going to be a different for that particular unit. Okay, so now from this particular, suppose if you are indicating this as PGI axis, and here if you are using this as I axis, where I indicates the ith unit. So as I have indicated 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, so suppose there are k number of units, and I will take the variable I. So I is equals to 1, 2, 3, anything. So when we take particular unit, so in that case, so we can indicate that by say cost of that particular unit is CI, and the power generation of that unit is PGI. It can be PG1 versus C1 versus PG1, and also it can be C2 versus PG2. Likewise, it will continue up to CK versus PGK. Okay. So now here, if I try to obtain the slope of this particular curve here, okay, so this looks like a almost linear type of curve. So we can obtain, try to obtain a slope for this. So here the slope will be obtained as, so here this will be del of CI this side, and here it will be del of PGI. Okay, so therefore here the slope हियर लेट मी जस्ट राइट द कंप्लीट थिंग हियर के सो स्लोप डी सी आई डिवाइडेड बाय डी पी जी आई. ओके सो दिस इंडिकेट्स व्हाट दिस एक्चुअली इंडिकेट्स द इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट. दिस इज गोइंग टू बी अ इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट एंड फॉर डिफरेंट यूनिट्स दिस इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट इज गोइंग टू बी फिक्स्ड वैल्यू फॉर दैट पर्टिकुलर यूनिट. दैट मीन्स एज द पावर जनरेशन इंक्रीजेस करस्पॉन्डिंगली देर विल बी इंक्रीज इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ जनरेशन. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट और इट इज ऑल्सो कंसिडर्ड एज इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट. इंक्रीमेंटल रादर वी कैन राइट इट एज इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट. ओके इट इज इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट. इट इज फॉर द पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू ऑफ द पावर जनरेटेड. इफ इट इज इंक्रीज्ड फ्रॉम अ सर्टन वैल्यू देन देर विल बी करस्पॉन्डिंग इंक्रीज इन द कॉस्ट ऑफ द फ्यूल. सो दैट इज कॉल्ड एज इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट. ओके सो नाउ सपोज इफ आई टेक द यूनिट वन. सो इन केस ऑफ यूनिट वन सो दिस इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट विल बी इक्वल टू से इन दैट केस इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट आई विल जस्ट राइट इट एज इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट वन. सो दिस विल बी वॉट दिस विल बी इक्वल टू डी सी वन डिवाइडेड बाय डी पी जी वन. सिमिलरली इंक्रीमेंटल फ्यूल कॉस्ट टू विल बी इक्वल टू डी सी टू डिवाइडेड बाय डी पी जी टू. नाउ दिस इज गोइंग टू बी कंटिन्यूअसली यू कैन ऑब्टेन डिफरेंट इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट फॉर डिफरेंट यूनिट्स. ओके सो हियर दिस इज वन थिंग अबाउट द इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट एंड द सेकेंड थिंग इज ईच ऑफ दिस यूनिट इज गोइंग टू हैव अ डिफरेंट एफिशियंसी. ओके सो हियर दे आर गोइंग टू हैव अ डिफरेंट एफिशियंसी. सो फॉर द फर्स्ट यूनिट द एफिशियंसी विल बी डिफरेंट. इट माइट बी डिफरेंट देन द सेकेंड यूनिट. इट माइट बी हायर और लोअर. इट डिपेंड्स अपॉन द एंटायर यू कैन से कॉम्बिनेशन ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर यूनिट. सो अगेन द एफिशियंसीज आर गोइंग टू बी डिफरेंट. ओके सो देयरफॉर फॉर डिफरेंट यूनिट्स यू कैन एक्सपेक्ट टू हैव डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिफरेंट यू कैन से वैल्यूज ऑफ एफिशियंसीज. ओके सो सम माइट बी ऐसे वर्किंग एट 50%. सम माइट बी वर्किंग एट 55%. सम माइट बी वर्किंग बिलो 50%. 30%. 35%. एनीथिंग पॉसिबल यू कैन इमेजिन. ओके सो नाउ हैविंग अंडरस्टूड द कॉन्सेप्ट हियर दैट देर विल बी डिफरेंट इंक्रीमेंटल कॉस्ट फॉर ईच ऑफ द यूनिट एंड देर विल बी डिफरेंट एफिशियंसी फॉर ईच ऑफ द यूनिट. नाउ लेट अस ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड हाउ वी कैन मैनेज द इकोनॉमिक ऑपरेशन ऑफ दिस पावर प्लांट. सो नाउ बेसिकली पावर प्लांट इज ऑपरेटेड फॉर वॉट. सो देर विल बी अ मैक्सिमम डिमांड. ओके सो देर विल बी अ डिमांड फ्रॉम द कंज्यूमर. सो दैट डिमांड नीड्स टू बी सेटिस्फाइड. सो इन दैट वे ओनली यूजुअली द पावर प्लांट इज ऑपरेटेड. सो द डिमांड शुड बी ऑलवेज मेट. And this demand will be equal to how it will be equal to met. So it will depend upon the different units working. So here first generator is going to generate something, second generator is going to generate something. Okay, so third generator is going to some portion of that, so on it will continue. So finally it is going to give us the total value which will be equal to the demand. So this will come from the consumer. Okay, so this will come from the consumer and this is given by the generating station. Okay, so this has to be met by generating station. So demand has to be met by the generating station or the power plant. So basically what we can write is whatever demand is coming, so that can be obtained as the summation of the different we can say power generated. So therefore I can indicate this as I equal to 1 to k. If suppose there are k units in one particular plant, so in that case I can just write this as pgi and this will be equal to what? The demand. Okay, so this is the basic equation you need to remember. Okay, so whatever demand is whatever consumers want to consume the power, so that power needs to be generated by the entire power plant and that power plant is having a number of units which are nothing but number of units are where k is the number of units. Okay, it is just number of units. It is a positive constant indicating some number of units. It might be having 4 units, 5 units, etc. So each of the unit will have its own capacity Okay, so it one of the unit might be 10 megawatts, other unit might be 20 megawatt, some other unit might be 50 megawatt. Because usually what will happen when the power plant is installed, it is not directly installed with the entire, you can say, plan of so many units. Okay, so in the beginning, suppose in this year to 2020, we require certain expected amount of power. So therefore, only one or two units in that power plant might be initiated, operated. Then in the coming year, suddenly when the demand rises, in that case, these two units are going to come to their capacities. They cannot generate more than their capacities. In that case, next unit needs to be added up. So third unit will come up. Likewise, fourth unit, fifth unit, so on. K number of units will be available in one power plant. Okay, so now the this power plant will be having multiple units which needs to be operated economically. Economically means what? After paying all the expenses, that is after paying the fuel cost, after paying the wages of the employers, all the workers in the power plant. Okay, after so you can say calculating all the expenses incurring for overall operation of the plant, then whatever remains is called as the revenue. Okay, and that revenue is to, you can say, recover the amount invested in the installation of that particular power plant. So okay, so therefore every power plant has to work operate so as to generate some revenue so that it can recover the installation cost. Therefore, you should understand why we need to operate it economically. If you do not operate it economically, then what will happen? Obviously, the power plant is going to incur losses. It is not going to recover the amount invested in the installation, and therefore it is going to be working under loss. So, which is not a good idea for any of the you can say working power plant. So therefore, what we need to do right now here is that, so we have to try to operate the power plant economically. Okay, so therefore, what we need to do in that case, we have to load the power plant, you can say different units of the power plant, so systematically, instead of just loading them as and when the demand comes up. So instead of doing that, the different units needs to be loaded systematically. Systematically means what? So there will be a particular person who is called as a control engineer, or he is also called as the load dispatcher. He has to consider a number of factors while interchanging energy from one power station to another power station, or one unit to another unit. How much energy is to be interchanged? How much cost of supplying energy will incur to the interconnection, or how much cost will incur to receive the energy from the interconnections? So all these things needs to be considered. Okay, so for that purpose, there has to be some economically operating phenomena that has to be followed. There have to be some conditions to be followed in order to get the economical operation of the power plant. So for that, what we need to do is we have to load the power plant, you can say, very in a proper way, so that we get the maximum profit from the power plant. Instead of incurring the losses, we have to get maximum efficiency, also maximum profit from the power plant. Okay, so now let us see the different types of loading that we usually find in the power plant. Okay, so let us consider the methods of loading. Okay, so what is method loading? So when there is a demand, okay, suppose I have 5 units. Okay, each unit is going to generate, say 5 units are there, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. And say my first unit was, say, 20 megawatt capacity, then my second unit is also 20 megawatt, then demand increased, therefore the third unit installed was of 30 megawatt. Then fourth unit would be, say, only 10 megawatt, and the fifth unit is, say, 30 megawatt. Okay, so these are just example values. So now these are different megawatt values. Okay, so totally the total installed capacity of this plant will be equal to sum of all these values. This 20 plus 20, 40, 40 plus 60, 100, 110 megawatt. Say one power plant is having 110 megawatt installed capacity. okay, so that is the maximum power it can generate at any given point of time. Now it depends upon the demand. Say the demand right now is, say PD is equals to PD1 is say 50 megawatt. Okay, so 50 megawatt. So now when the demand is 50 megawatt, so in that case here how many number of units are to be operated? So that is the question. So here unit 1, unit 2 together will make 40. Okay, so these are going to make 40, and then there is unit 4 which is 10 megawatt. So therefore together it can become 50 megawatt. But why to choose only 20, 20 and 10? We can also choose unit number 1 and unit number 3, or unit number 1, unit number 5, or unit number 2, unit number 3, or unit number 2, unit number 5. The question is here that which of the units are to be chosen. Now next thing is to look for the two important parameters. One is the incremental fuel cost and another one is the efficiency, because each of these are going to have different incremental costs and each of these are going to have different efficiencies. So if the incremental cost is low, that unit is to be selected because it is going to be economical, and if the efficiency is high, that unit needs to be given preference, as the high efficiency means again low cost. Okay, so simple logic we have to apply in order to, so you can say, operate the power plant so as to supply that demand with economical operation. Okay, so now how to do the loading? So very basic method of loading is based on the incremental cost. Okay, so based on incremental cost only the most of the time the loading is done. Okay, so as I explained you, so if the incremental cost is low, suppose if the unit is having low incremental cost, that unit needs to be selected for supplying the load. Okay, so this is what we have to follow. Okay, so here different incremental costs, fuel costs will be there. Okay, IFC1, IFC2, IFC, no matter what is the you can say generating capacity, so incremental fuel cost is going to be say almost same for each of this. Little bit change will be there, one will be higher, one will be smaller, like that. Suppose if I say that the incremental cost of the unit IFC2 is the lowest. Okay, then next is the IFC1, then third is IFC5. Okay, and then which is also greater than, sorry, less than the remaining, say IFC3, and then finally IFC4. So here which is smaller, that we need to select first. So IFC2 is smaller than IFC1, is smaller than like that. Okay, so you understood the order here with respect to incremental cost. So here incremental cost is increasing in this direction. Okay, so we have to select the different units in this order only. Okay, so that is what we are going to do. Suppose if I want 50 megawatt, now which units are to be selected for 50 megawatt depending upon this whatever I have written. So based on that you can try to understand which units needs to be operated. So IFC2 is how much? 20 megawatt. Okay, then IFC1 value is also 20 megawatt. Then there is IFC5 is how much? 30. Then IFC4, so IFC4 where incremental cost is higher. So instead of choosing IFC2, IFC1 and IFC4, we can choose IFC2 and then IFC5. Okay, IFC2 and plus IFC5. Okay, so this will be say the selected value. So here for that particular unit was, so this is unit 2, unit 1, unit 5, unit 3, 3 and unit 4. So we are going to select unit 2 plus unit 5. So how much is unit 2? Unit 2 is 20 megawatt and unit 5 is 30 megawatt. So we are going to get 50 megawatt. Okay, so here it is expected that when we operate unit 2 and unit 5, so in that case the power plant is operating at the economical cost. That means it is going to generate some profit, it is not going to incur losses. Okay, so this is the way you can understand what is the loading of power plant or different units of the power plant, or you can say sometimes this is also called as turbo alternator. Okay, turbo alternator because finally the combination is one turbine connected to an alternator, so it is called as loading of turbo alternator also, which is nothing but unit. Okay, so because the turbine is rotating because the boiler is giving the steam. Okay, so boiler is supplying steam to the turbine, so turbine is rotating and it is also rotating the alternator to generate the electricity. So that is how it is one unit. Okay, so loading of unit is nothing but loading of turbo alternator also. So this is the most commonly used method of loading, but apart from this there are different loading methods also available, so those can also be considered. So the very first method here apart from this is that I want to write here right now is the first one is, okay, so other methods I'll write, other loading methods. So you need to remember these methods as well. Okay, so sometimes these are also used, sometimes these are not used. The very first method is called as base load to capacity. Here basically what will happen, say for a particular power plant there will be a base load, say 50 megawatt. I took the example, so 50 megawatt is a base load. Okay, so that base load will be supplied by the most economic units. Then thereafterwards what will happen, suddenly at some point the load is going to increase. Okay, so that sudden increase in the load needs to be now supplied by some other unit. Okay, so this is the increased in the load. So here it was 50 megawatt and now here it will be say 70 megawatt. Suddenly it will become 70 megawatt. Okay, so now this needs to be supplied. Okay, so up to this you can take it as a base load, and above that it will be some added load on the base load. Okay, so that 20 megawatt is the additional load. Now that 20 megawatt additional load needs to be applied on the other units. Okay, now how to choose the other units? So that is nothing but base load to capacity. In this method the different units are successively loaded to capacity in the order of their efficiencies, in the order of efficiencies. Okay, so this is very important here, in the order of their efficiencies. So different units are successively loaded means what? So suppose one unit is having certain efficiency and its capacity is reached, then next highest efficiency unit is considered and that will be loaded, so that the finally that increase in the demand is met. Okay, so that is what is done. So the base load is supplied by the economical units, and above that, so based on the whichever unit is having highest efficiency, so in order of that efficiency, so the units are selected to supply the additional loads. Okay, then here it is assumed. Okay, so here it is not sure that whether the overall operation is going to be most economical or not, but it is assumed that so the overall result will be high in efficiency. Okay, so it is assumed here, it is not for sure. Okay, so similarly we have the next type. Okay, so the next type is base load to most efficient load. Okay, so here it is base load to most efficient load. So in the earlier case, what happened? Apart from base load, if there is any increase in the demand, so that was supplied by the efficient units. But here in this case, instead of being supplied by the efficient units, in this base load to most efficient load, so whichever unit is operating at best efficiency at a particular load. Okay, so suppose if I try to draw the efficiency curve, so some of the so for the say some of the units will have different efficiency curves. Okay, so sometimes the efficiency is going to remain constant at some point and then it might decrease. Suppose if the efficiency curve is like this. Okay, so here you can take this as the maximum point at which efficiency occurs, and this is the some PG value. Okay, so it is neither minimum nor maximum, it is the optimum value. Okay, optimum I can say, at which maximum efficiency, this is efficiency occurs. So therefore that particular loading will be done on that unit instead of applying the full load on that unit. So only amount of the load at which that unit is acting as most efficient. Okay, so it is efficient load operation of the unit, so that unit is selected. Okay, so it is not that it is having the highest efficiency. Overall efficiency might be lower, but it is having high efficiency at a particular point. So that is first considered, and that is used for the supply of that. And then there is another unit which is going to have similar type of curve, and it is going to have a different efficiency at different load. So therefore, if that efficiency is higher than this efficiency at that load, then that unit is considered. So here units are selected based on their efficiency at a particular load value. It is not that overall efficiency of the unit. So that is called as base load to most efficient load. In this method, various units are successfully loaded to their most efficient loads in the ascending order of their heat rates. Okay, after that all the units are loaded to the capacity in the same order. Even after doing all the units to their maximum efficient load value, still if there is requirement of the say much more demand is there and it is not sufficient to satisfy that demand with the most efficient load condition of all the units, then again from in the order of efficiencies we have to go on increasing the capacity. So whichever unit is giving the highest efficiency, that unit has to be first reached to full capacity, then the next unit will be selected which will reach to its maximum efficiency, and when it till it reaches to its capacity. Similarly, we have the third type, which is called as loading proportional to capacity. Loading proportional to capacity. Okay, so here basically what will happen when the different units are there, so they will have different capacities. Okay, so if you take the ratio, say here total whatever say 5 units are there, and suppose the 100 megawatt is there, so one unit might be having 2 is to say here 3. Okay, and then 3, so like this. Now or here a different value can also be taken. Okay, so instead of this I can take it as 1. Okay, so now how much it is 2 4 7 8, and then okay, so you can take it as 3 only. So now depending upon the unit's value, unit's capacities, in that proportion the load is divided. Suppose 50 is megawatt is the demand. Okay, so 2 shares of that 50 megawatt is shared with this means applied to first unit, then 2 units, 2 shares of that 50 is applied here, then 3 shares here and 3 shares here. Okay, so we have to make totally 4 parts, and in that case here totally 10 parts we have to make, and 2 parts are supplied to each of the first 2 units, and 3 parts are supplied to okay, so 3 parts are supplied to, so here suppose 10 megawatt, then 3 parts means 15 total 50 megawatt divided by 10, so each will be 5 megawatt each part. Okay, one part is 5 megawatt, so two part is nothing but so 10 megawatt, 15 15. Okay, so like this the total loading is done on the loading proportional to capacity kind of loading. Okay, then finally there is fourth and the last type of loading method, which is loading proportional to most efficient load. Loading proportional to most efficient load. Okay, so in this case what will happen, in this method the units are loaded in proportion to their most efficient loads. After the units are loaded up to their most efficient loads, the additional load on each unit is made proportional to their to the difference between the rated capacity and the most efficient load. Okay, it is similar to the most efficient base load to most efficient load only, but here basically what is done, in the first case itself all the units are selected according to their best most efficient load type of units. There is no first base load and then finally it is like that. Total loading is done like that. Okay, so first of all most efficient units are most efficient load units are selected, then whatever remaining load will be there, so that will be again done in the order of again in the same order like most efficient loads only. So remaining part will again go, it will be given to each of the units so that the final demand is reached here. Okay, so this is how the loading is done. I hope you are able to understand the economic operation of the power system with the help of this simple understanding, whatever I have tried to convey to you with the help of this here. So in the coming video lectures we are going to explore some of the very important concepts of this economic operation of the power plant. We are going to obtain some of the mathematical expressions which are required to support whatever assumption we are making that it is going to be economical or not. Okay, so I hope you will continue to watch the video lectures. Okay, so till then happy learning and thank you.